like one summer's night, a stranger at my door. There came a knocking from below, a noise to be explored. I ventured there to see who would awake me from my bed. Outside there was an empty space, a dream, a wish, my dread. So back to slumber I did go, but tossed and turned because the noise I did hear it again, much louder than before. The door I knew I had to go and open it once more. And this time stood a girl before me, ghostly pale with fear.
Servant girl, won't you run and hide, won't you? Inside the wood, servant girl, won't you run and hide, won't you take yourself from here, deep inside the wood.
I invited her into the house to warm her by the fire. I noticed there were cuts around her neck and bruises high. I asked her why she was so scared. She told me she was chased. A man had locked her up and used her at his pleasure's taste. This house, she said, was in the woods, Lady Bonnet's own. To the woods, go down the track and upon a bridge you'll come. I went to get some drink and bandages to tend her wounds. When I returned to find her gone, just a cold and empty room.
Servant girl, won't you run and hide, won't you take yourself from here, deep inside the wood. Servant girl, won't you run and hide, won't you take yourself from here, deep inside the wood.
So the next day I decided to try to find this house. Perhaps the girl was still in need. Get out. Deep into the wood I ventured. I could not find the thing till a small stone bridge came into view and a track to follow on.
Followed the track through the forest, darkness everywhere, till the outline of a building appeared in the misty air. A house that was deserted, no person did live here. With a boarded door and a window sash, not a home it had been for years. Servant girl, won't you run and hide, won't you take yourself from here, deep inside the wood. Servant girl, won't you run and hide, won't you take yourself from here, deep inside the wood.
Lying on the ground, a piece of glass, the window, the jagged edges turned my mind to the poor girl's savage throat. I ran the route back through the forest, keen to be at home, till crossing the stone bridge a movement caused me to turn round.
The girl was stood there in plain sight, a shard of glass in hand, a fresh wound on her neck that would have killed a full grown man. I froze, I couldn't move. A figure stood in front of me, a shadow not of flesh and blood, but a spectre I did see. The truth now I did understand, it's busy from the passage home to
yourself from here, deep inside the wood.